You know, the fact that you have mental versions of these is all the reason you need to be able to succeed in every aspect of your life. Yo, what's up everybody? How you doing? This is your coach Renz, and I want to thank everybody who's a supporter of this channel. Whether you're supporting this channel through liking this video, whether you support this channel by subscribing, or if you support this channel in a very special way to me through Patreon, I greatly appreciate it and I thank you for that. But let me not take too much more of your time. In the introduction, I said if you have a mental, you have a mental version of these. And that is what makes you different. That's what makes you different from every other creature on this planet that gives you the ability to succeed. You see, when I was growing up and I was taking biology classes, like many of you probably remember now, in biology, they told you one of the things that separated man from every other creature on the planet is the fact of the opposable thumb. The opposable thumb allows you to be separated from almost, and see, they said every, but it's almost every creature on the planet. And we're gonna get to the almost in just a second. Just for you guys who don't remember, because I know it's been a long time since you've been in school, the opposable thumb allows you to hold tools, allows you to hold things, to grasp things. If the lion could hold tools, could grasp things, it would and then be able to create and hold the gun, then who would win, the hunter or the lion? The hunter or the lion, which would win if the lion could hold the gun, point it, aim it, shoot it? Who would win, the hunter or the lion? Would the lion be able to save and conserve his energy and not have to chase down the water buffalo if it could hold the gun? So the opposable thumb allows us to create and hold things, hold tools to make things, to bring things into reality, to bring our thoughts into reality, the opposable thumb. But I said most animals, the chimpanzee, the monkey, the ape, the gorilla, they all have the opposable thumb as well. They can all grasp things as well. Some other animals, they have claws and they're able to hold things and grasp things. A few of them, sloths, can hold on and grasp. But they're missing something. They're missing something that's keeping them from being on equal level with you. And what is that? Now, I'm not saying we evolved from any of these animals, but what is it that they're missing? They're missing cognitive thought to be able to critically think, to be able to set for themselves tasks, to be able to see something and reason it into existence. You have an opposable thumb of your brain that allows you to hold on to thoughts and imaginations and tools that allows you to be able to grow and become whatever it is that you desire. The problem is we're not using it. You see, the monkey is not using his opposable thumb to create tools because they're missing that cognitive portions of their brain to be able to do that. But you have that ability, but we're not using it. Oftentimes, just like the monkey, most people are just using what is available to them. The ape uses the tree to climb and escape because it's available to them and the opposable thumb allows them to grasp it and climb up. They may use a twig or a branch to scratch or whatever because the opposable thumb allows them to grab, but they're only able to use what's in front of them to put these things together in different complex scenarios in order to create something. It's not a talent that they have. They don't have that ability to be able to create and build a city. They don't have that ability to figure out flight. They don't have the ability to change the nature of their basic instincts. But you do. You have that ability. And I woke up this morning thinking about how we grasp things. Without the opposable thumb, we could claw a few things. We could kind of sort of hold on to a few things. But that opposable thumb allows you to grasp, to hold. Your ability to critically think allows you to grasp, to hold. But we're not using it. I sat down with a client yesterday, and before I go further, thank you Riri Hai for visiting with me the other day. It was a pleasure to talk to you and enjoy your company, but put a picture of her up here. I was sitting with a client yesterday, a financial alchemy client, and while sitting with that client, one of the first questions I asked, how much would it take for you to live? How much money does it take for you to live your life a comfortable, whatever way you want to live your life, up to your standard? She had no answer. She could not answer the question. Then I asked her, okay, think about it. How much would it take? Let's go through the process. And initially, she was wavering, baffled. Couldn't figure it out. Couldn't think straight through it. Her focus started being only on her bills, her current lifestyle, the current troubles and stresses that she's dealing with. She couldn't necessarily think straight. So we had to take a moment to breathe, to meditate, to center herself. And then we took a moment and wrote out a list of how you would want to live your life. What do you need to have in your life? And then what is it that you desire to have in your life? After looking at her needs and looking at her desires, we began to eliminate what were true needs and what were false needs, what were true desires and what were just wants. And as we narrowed that down, we began to put a price on it. And as we put that price on it, it became clear as to how much money she needs in order to live the life she desires. We critically thought, we got all the input. After we got the input, we then came up with what that input brings out. What's the result of the input? And now it's just putting it into action. It's moving forward in certain ways and using tools to put it into action. But the initial thing is that she's been going all these years not knowing this number. Many of you are going all your years not knowing that number. You haven't critically thought it. Many of you will just shout out, I need $6,000 in order to live, $6,000 a month to live the way I want to live, because right now I'm making three or four, and making this three and four, I see the stress that I have in my life. So I know if I just have six, then I wouldn't have it. The problem is you're not accounting for the fact that if you were to slowly acquire the $6,000 a month, as most people do, you will begin to spend up to that $6,000 a month and find yourself in the same situation, saying now I need $8,000. You have to critically think it out, critically put it down and understand it. And then after you get the knowledge and you get the understanding, then you can walk in the wisdom of it. We're gonna talk more deeply about that in another video later. But then once you get that, we're gonna talk about the Da Vinci effect. When you get that, then you'll be able to think critically. Many of you are, I want a husband, I want a wife, I want a companion, I want a family. Have you thought about it? Have you critically listed out what it is that you would like in a mate? How does that life live? How is that life lived? What is it about you that would attract the type of person that you're desiring? What type of lifestyle would both of you want to have and desire to have? Have you considered those things? Have you gotten the knowledge about self, about you, so that you can understand what your standards are? And in knowing your standard, it gives you an outlook of what it is that you should be looking for. And then when you look for it and when you find it, have you considered things that can distract you and keep you from being able to recognize any red flags, but also recognize any green flags? Can't always go into it looking for the negative of the situation. We have to also look for what are the greater things that we did not see before. What are the things that we've had a mindset about but missed out on because we didn't recognize the green flags? That's a whole nother video as well. It's a video concerning my book that I'm writing, How to Find Your Divine Soulmate. But we haven't thought about these things. We haven't critically thought about them. We haven't gained all the input so that we can have a great understanding of it and then walk in the wisdom of it. Because once you know it, then you can start putting it into practice. If you know the type of person that you desire is the kind that goes to museums and you say to yourself, I haven't been going to museums myself, then how do you expect to find the person who loves going to the museum? If they love poetry, but you are not at the events or on the blogs of poetry, then how are you going to find the poetic person? You won't find them sitting at home, dreaming about it, meditating about it, praying about it. They're not just going to knock on your door. You're going to have to take action based on your knowledge and the understanding of that knowledge. And as you do that, you look for the green flags just as much as the red flags. But we're not critically thinking in every aspect of our life. We're not using the opposable thumbs of our brain so that we can then have that greater version of ourselves and have the greater life. You see, I put in a post on my Facebook page today when you bring order to your chaos, then life will bend to your will. Bring order to your chaos so that life can bend to your will. Critically thinking, gaining the understanding of the knowledge that you have and the knowledge that you acquire and putting it into action. Looking at the results, determining if they're giving you the desired results. If not, what changes need to be made in order to gain the desired results. That is critically thinking in infinite form. And if you do that, life will bend to your will. Life will give you what you desire and what you deserve. But it's up to you to do it. Use the opposable thumbs of your brain to grasp the life that you deserve. And remember always, you have to free yourself to be yourself, because your greatness is non-negotiable.